Today we are going to test the Apple Watch Series 10. This watch was released together with the iPhone 16 series. Compared with the previous generation, it has not changed much, but it has added titanium material, a slightly narrower bezel, a thinner body, and an S10 SIP chip. In terms of battery capacity, the 42mm version of Series 10 is 290 mAh, and the 45mm version is 327 mAh, which is much smaller than the 564 mAh of Ultra 2. Compared with the previous generation S9 and earlier S8, the 42mm version has a slightly larger battery, and the 46mm version has a slightly smaller battery. It still comes with a USB-C magnetic charging cable. The woven nylon strap is made from 100% recycled material. The length of the cable is about 1 meter. Model is A2879. It can support the input of 5 volts 1 amp. The 42mm Series 10 has a resolution of 374 by 446, and the screen is 1mm larger than the S9, but the maximum brightness is still 2000 nits. The shell of this model is made of aluminum alloy, weighs 30 grams, and is 9.7 millimeters thick. Compared with the previous generation 41mm aluminum alloy GPS version, the thickness is reduced by 1mm and the weight is reduced by 1.9 grams. The changes are not obvious. The side speaker opening has been changed from a single slit to a honeycomb-shaped opening. It incorporates a depth gauge capable of measuring both water depth and temperature, has a water resistance rating of 50 meters, and is also rated IP6X dust resistant. Next, let's do the full charging test. Under normal conditions, the input power is between 2 to 3 watts. We use the Apple 20-watt charger and the original cable to fully charge the Apple Watch Series 10, and put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. The voltage is always around 5 volts. The charging curve can be divided into 3 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 2.5 watts for the first 3 minutes. After that, the power kept fluctuating up and down for a period of time, until 1 hour and 7 minutes, the power dropped to 1.6 watts and began to decrease steadily. It takes 1 hour and 36 minutes to be fully charged. It takes 38 minutes to charge to 50%, 1 hour and 2 minutes to charge to 80%, and 1 hour and 36 minutes to charge to 100%. Compared with the S8 and S9, which can charge to 80% in 45 minutes, it is much slower. Putting the speed curves of S8 and S10 together, we can see that S8 is significantly faster than S10. The full charging time of the S10 is half an hour slower. Although the Apple Watch Series 10 uses the same charger as before, the actual charging power is almost halved, with a peak of about 2.5 watts. It takes about an hour to charge 80%, and 1 hour and 36 minutes to be fully charged. There have been improvements in other aspects, such as the new S10 chip, a lighter and thinner body, a better screen, etc., which can also improve the daily wearing experience. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.